Well, my year 8 students have been studying plate tectonics, and after talking about the topic and learning about it, they've had to create their own instructional video explaining how that works. I try to use a variety of sources, including videos, PowerPoint presentations, images, and interactive websites to try and engage students in my classes. So usually I use them when I'd like to introduce a new topic or consolidate something that we've already learned. So, first of all, we're going to talk about plate tectonic theory. So we all know that the Earth's crust is made up of hard rock. Now, some plates are moving towards each other. We call these converging or destructive plate boundaries. So I can ask you to copy that down. So we have one plate on the top here, the continental plate, and the oceanic plate is moving towards it. So as they move towards, one goes below and down into that mantle. So in some areas where it's very destructive, so around the Pacific Rim, it causes huge earthquakes. And that can then cause that water to be displaced and we get tsunamis. So the words that are written in colours, remember the key words. So they're the terms we have to remember, especially for Monday when you're creating your own little movie. So which ones do you think are going to move more quickly, the continental plates or the oceanic plates? What do you think, Tom?
I think the oceanic plates will move.
Why do you think so?
Because they're lighter.
That's correct. So in pairs tomorrow, or Monday, sorry, you're going to be creating your own little Puppet Pals presentation using cartoon characters and your own voiceover to create a movie that explains this. So your job for the rest of the lesson is to come up with a script on how you could explain this to someone who doesn't know anything about it. Make sure you're using those key words that were in colour. And make sure you have a clearly laid out script so that when you get the iPads on Monday, you're ready to go with what you need to do. The students went home and they created their own script of how they were going to write this. We had an explanation lesson where I showed them a Puppet Pals that I'd created about plate tectonics, and we looked at how to use the program. Then we had a lesson where the students had their scripts ready and they could explain the plate tectonics using the script, and they already knew how to use the program.
So you're okay, girls?
Yeah. Well, yep. Is that right? So not to do
that one. So that one just shows how the Earth's surface is cracked.
Yeah, that's cool.
So what else do we need to get an image for?
We need to get an image for the actual Pangaea.
Yep, Pangaea, yeah. And also the plate movements.
Yeah. So you got Pangaea. What's this one for?
The Earth's plates.
Yep, and this one.
The movement of the plates.
Plates as well as that one.
Yep.
Okay, perfect. So now the next stage is choosing your characters, or you've chosen your characters?
Yeah.
Oh, excellent. Okay.
Yeah.
So next one, you've chosen your backgrounds. You're ready to get them all ready and record. All right.
So after that, we gave them a chance to watch their programs, comment on each other's, and look at things that they think they could do better next time. And then we had a lesson where they could redo it if they wanted to. And in the end, they put together some really great presentations and they had a really great understanding of the topic because they've had to create it themselves.
Today we are going to talk about tectonic plates. The Earth has four sections. The inner core, here, the outer core, the mantle, and the crust. There are 7 large and 12 small plates, like here. These are the Earth's major plates.
This may also be known as called constructive plate boundaries.
Sliding boundaries are when the plates slide past each other in the opposite direction.
So I try to select a variety of resources to use in the classroom depending on what topic we're doing. So I select something that I think will help to either explain the topic the best or that the students can use to explain a topic the best. In the case of ICT resources, we chose Puppet Pals for their plate tectonics explanation, because it meant that they could do it together and it allowed them to give a full explanation as well as having visuals there.